Hello and welcome back in the third episode of The Evolution of Vilppu. Today I finally talk about the evolution system. First of all, I need a graph because I want to show how the population of these little creatures evolve over time. I go on Google and search how to create graph on Python. I don't understand a single word, so I decided to create one from my own. This is more or less the result. Now I will introduce you some evolution mechanics. I call n of t the population of Vilppu at a given time, and I denote with delta n of t the increment of the same population at the same time. If delta n is positive, in the next unit of time, the total number of creatures will increase. Vice versa, if delta n is negative, in the next period, we will have a decreasing population. The last case is when delta n is equal to zero, and in that case, the population does not change. For the first example, I start a simulation with 50 Vilppus. At a given instant, every Vilppu has a 0.5% of probability to die. Therefore, I can write delta n of t is equal minus 0.005 multiplied by n of t. Now, what is the behavior that you expect from the total population in this condition? This is not surprising at all. If a single Vilppu can only die, the total population can only go extinct. But let us see mathematically why this is true. The population at time t plus 1 is the same population at time t plus the increment. And in this case, the increment is minus alpha n, where alpha is the death chance, 0.5%. So globally, n of t plus 1 is equal n of t multiplied by 1 minus alpha. So let's try to calculate the population in the t plus 2. It will be the population at t plus 1 multiplied by 1 minus alpha from the previous formula. But thanks to the previous formula, we can substitute also n t plus 1, obtaining the population in the t period multiplied by 1 minus alpha elevated to the second power. And in general, we can substitute the 2 with whatever n integer. Thus, if you know the initial number of creatures and 0, we know the population decreases exponentially. I can plot on Desmos this exponential, and it looks really like the one that we obtained in the simulation. If you understood this, try to answer this question. What happened now if I triple the death chance? The population goes extinct faster, because at a given time, the probability that a Vilppu die is 3 times as before. You can simply visualize this on Desmos. Now I complicate a bit the behavior. In nature, animals die but also reproduce. To start creating account of this behavior, I implement a born chance. At a given time, there is a 2% of probability that a Vilppu is created out of nothing. I know this is not realistic, but in future episode I will fix this. Now the equation of the increment becomes minus the population at times t multiplied by the death chance plus the born chance. What do you think will happen in this case? Do the population go extinct as before? The answer in this case is more problematic. In the first part of the simulation, we have an exponential behavior like before, but after a transition, the population tends to a stable value that mathematician calls equilibrium point. How can we calculate it? As I said at the beginning, if delta n reaches zero, the population doesn't change at all. But this is exactly what an equilibrium is. So let's put delta n equal to zero and see what happens. we calculate that the n equilibrium point is equal beta divided by alpha. With this in mind, what do you think will happen if we double the Born chance? The initial behavior does not change so much, but the equilibrium point is changed, and in particular is double, as expected from the formula. Obviously, this is not what happens in nature, because a creature doesn't pop up from nothing. But I think that this is a good starting point for the next episode. So I hope you enjoy it, and see you next episode.